Welcome to Venus Flytrap World. In today's video, I'm going to be debunking 5 Venus Flytrap care myths that sometimes you hear out there but are not actually true and can end up killing your plant. So please pay close attention. The first one of these myths is that Venus flytraps require indirect sunlight. Venus flytraps actually require direct sunlight to stay healthy. They need a minimum of 6 hours, and optimally they should receive more than 10. So please do not be afraid to place your Venus flytrap outdoors under direct sunlight. They are very resilient plants and they can withstand temperatures of up to 100 Fahrenheit. Another myth is that tap water is safe for Venus flytraps. Venus flytraps are very sensitive to minerals that are present in most tap water and bottled water. For that reason, it is recommended to employ pure water sources such as distilled water, rainwater, or RO water. These 3 types of water are completely pure and safe for Venus flytraps. Tap water could be pure enough to be suitable for Venus flytraps, but unless you have tested it with a TDS meter, there's really no way to know, and I wouldn't risk it, as using the incorrect water source can actually end up killing your plant. Another related myth is that boiling tap water will make it suitable for Venus flytraps. This statement is also incorrect, as boiling such tap water will increase the mineral content and make it actually worse for your plant. The third myth is that Venus flytraps require high humidity to survive. Venus flytraps thrive in humid environments, but they do not require high humidity. You can grow them in pretty dry locations and Venus flytraps will adapt. So do not go overly crazy and try to grow Venus flytraps, for example, in a terrarium just to account for that lack of humidity. Instead, focus on everything else. When you grow Venus flytraps in a terrarium, you end up taking away the bugs, you end up taking away the good airflow, and you end up putting the Venus flytrap in a position where it is very prone to root rot. So there is a lot more negatives than positives. The fourth myth is that Venus flytraps are tropical plants. Venus flytraps are not tropical plants. They're actually natives to the east coast of the United States, specifically to South Carolina and North Carolina. Because many people believe they are tropical, they think they should keep them at very mild weathers and warm year-round. But in reality, if you have been to that area in the United States, you might already know that in North Carolina or South Carolina, you can experience pretty hot summers, really all the seasons, including very chilly winters. Venus flytraps actually require cold weather to be able to stay healthy. They need to undergo a process called dormancy, which requires several months of winter. If you keep them in warm locations year-round to try to mimic the tropical conditions, then that just will kill the plant within only a couple of years. This last myth that I'm going to explain, I believe is actually one of the worst. But before that, if you have enjoyed this video, I'll really appreciate if you can hit the like button. It really helps me spread this information to more and more people. Now, the last myth. The last myth is that Miracle-Gro peat moss is perfectly safe for Venus flytraps. Like I discussed before, Venus flytraps are intolerant to minerals, additives, or fertilizers. And for that reason is that many people employ pure sphagnum peat moss or long fiber sphagnum moss to grow these plants. I actually do that too. But Miracle-Gro peat moss is quite different. It might be peat moss, but it is enhanced with tons of minerals and fertilizers that are great for most plants, but not for Venus flytraps. So Miracle-Gro will actually end up poisoning your plant and killing it very, very quickly. So avoid Miracle-Gro at all costs. It is very discouraging to get the wrong information when you are trying to grow a new plant and you actually end up killing it. Just having the correct instructions are step one. And this is what this channel is about, to provide very clear and correct instructions on growing Venus flytraps and other carnivorous plants. If that is something that you are interested in, please feel free to subscribe. Also, have you heard any other myths out there about carnivorous plant growing? Let me know. And thank you so much for watching.